Pinchas was shalem, and because of that, because he's shalem with himself, he can have a relationship with me as well and with others as well. A full and complete relationship. And that's why when Eliyahu Hanavi will come before Mashiach, Eliyahu Hanavi, right before Mashiach, Hineni Sholeach et Eliyahu Hanavi, Lifnei Bo Yom Hashem, Agadol Vanora. So, Chachamim tell us that Pinchas is Eliyahu. And the Mishnah in Eduyot says that En Eliyahu Ba Ela Lasot Shalom Ba'olam. Which means Eliyahu does that very job to spread shalom, peace between men and men. Why is that? Because Pinchas has that character trait of Aaron HaKohen, which is he's good with himself. Once a person is good with himself, he can give and do shalom to others as well. Now, this is a very big musar for us. Because if we're not feeling good with ourselves, we can't start building a relationship, not with others and not with a Kadosh Baruch Hu. This is the first building block to feel good about yourself. And you see that today, the way they teach Musar to people and to kids in school and people to their children is in a way that you pound them with Musar. You have to do this, you have to do that. And they put under pressure, whether it's peer pressure or the school pressure or Mashgiach pressure or whatever pressure people are in. And that pressure is not something that builds them in a right and constructive way. Because when you're under pressure, all you want to do is eventually take that yoke off yourself. As soon as you can, and your parents are not looking, or your Mashgiach is not looking, or your Rosh Yeshiva is not looking, or whatever it is, the society is not looking, you're out in vacation, you're just trying to take everything apart. Rather, the right way to do is make a person feel good about keeping the Torah and the mitzvot, which means you have to have that relationship, and that is called the relationship between a person and himself. When you come to the Torah, Torah teaches you how to, the Musar, the Pirkei Avot, as the Gemara explains in Bava Kamma Lamed, that Pirkei Avot comes to teach you at Kochot HaNefesh, that you should feel good about things. When you learn the Torah, you should not look at things as different things that you must do. It's different burdens that you have to take upon yourself, pressures and things like that, which then you're not going to be able to perform in the correct way. Rather, a person needs to understand that those things come, maybe it's a challenge, what the Torah tells you. There's different mitzvot that are challenges, but eventually what you need to look at it as a positive thing, something that is sweet, something that is good, and something that builds your inner feelings and your inner strengths, that you should be a better person. Once you're a better person, you become a happier person. So it's like an exercise. A person goes to gym, and in the beginning it could be hard, but he understands that those things are not just weights that you just try to finish and get it over with. Rather, it builds you up, it makes you better, and it makes you happier, it makes you healthier, and so on and so forth. That's what the Torah is about. When a person looks at it, views things in a correct manner, first thing he does, he builds himself, he's good with himself. Once he's good with himself, then he can have relationship with others. So that's something that's very important. When the Torah comes and speaks about the mitzvah of Ahavat Hashem, for instance, you have to love HaKadosh Baruch Hu. How are you supposed to love HaKadosh Baruch Hu? The Rishonim speak about how are you supposed to fear HaKadosh Baruch Hu? There's Yirat Hashem. Yirat Hashem. How are you supposed to fear HaKadosh Baruch Hu? I don't feel it. How are you supposed to feel such a thing? How the Torah commands me to do something that I don't feel? So, over here, the Rishonim have different, and the Achronim have different explanations. But when it comes to Ahavat Hashem, the Rambam also gives you an understanding of how to love HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He says that when you learn the Torah, and you learn about the world, and you see the beautiful things that Hashem created, so you come to love HaKadosh Baruch Hu. But that is true when you first have the base beforehand. You have to have, first of all, the core. You have to have something that you could build on those roots. And what are those roots? First of all, you have to feel good about yourself. So when you come to teach your kids, that's the basic. First, you have to believe in yourself. First, you have to feel good about yourself. When you feel good about yourself, then he would want to hear about HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And he wants to have a relationship with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And you'll see that in society, the people that go off the derech, it's almost 100% of the kids that go off the derech is because they didn't feel good about themselves, whether they came from a broken family or from a broken society or from different... They grew up in a school where the kids made fun of them. Let's say they weren't so good in sports. So in that school, the kids gave a lot of importance to being good at sports. So they put him down because he's not good at sports. Whatever it is, a kid that starts feeling not good about himself, he starts feeling a low self-esteem, those are the kids that in much higher danger of falling off religion. Why is that? Because they're not feeling good about themselves. When you don't feel good about yourself, you don't feel good about the Kadosh Baruch Hu as well. You don't feel good about society at large. You don't feel good about anything. That's the basic. When a person feels good about himself because he has a good family, the people that are supportive of him, he goes to school and he has people over there that love him. So he feels good about himself. That's a very important block that on that you can build the building afterwards of Ahavat Hashem, Ahavat HaBriyot, and it reflects afterwards to having also a good relationship with your husband and wife and your children, because if you feel good about yourself, you can reflect that to your children and to your wife and husband. So this is something that's very important for us to understand. First of all, it's for us. We need to learn as ourselves. What are we? Just like we explained before, like a sugiyah, what are we? What makes me upset? Why am I not feeling good about this or that? And get to that and improve that as much as we can. And sometimes we don't know how to do that, so we need to seek help from others. But sometimes it's not only us. We can help others as well. And first you have to try to do that in your inner family. You have your wife, you have your husband, you have your children. Your wife, people feel that I do so much for my wife and she's not happy. I give her this, I take her here, I give her compliments, all kind of things, and she's still not happy. Whatever I do, she's not happy. Normally, the reason a person is not happy is because he's not happy with himself. If he's not happy with himself, it's not going to make him happy or her happy if you take him to trips, if you make him coffee, if you this, if you that. Those things are external things. First, he has to feel the inner happiness. How do you do that? You build the person up. You are a very special person. So if he starts believing in himself, it's work. But after he starts believing in himself, you have yourself a happy person. Once it's a happy person, then everything you do good for them, that shines in a different light. But if he's not happy, everything you'll do would be dimmed. It's not going to help. So this is a very big and important piece of information that we learn from Parashat Pinchas. Pinchas, automatically, is looked at as somebody that's doing something negative. You are negative, and therefore what you did is not accepted, right?
You've just experienced another Torah class brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.